皆さんですね、すごくこうお待たせはしてないのかもしれないんですが。
Well, the time has come to answer fan requests and reveal to you Super Street Fighter 4, which is kind of an official sequel to the Street Fighter 4 that you know and love.
まずスーパーストリートファイター2からですね、T-Hawk。
So first of all, I'll talk about the returning characters from Super Street Fighter 2, which would be T-Hawk and DJ.As you know, they were left out of Street Fighter 4. We had initially intended to try and put them in there, but you know, things got down to the wire and it just looked like there was going to be a lot of balance adjustments and things that were going to be needed to accommodate them. And it was just decided at that point to just kind of leave them on the cutting room floor. Some fans were pretty disappointed by that, more so than I had expected. Honestly, a lot of people were disappointed that, you know, we were having this grand reunion with all the characters from Street Fighter 2, and those two didn't show up. So this time around, I was sure to write out a proper invitation to him, put a stamp on it, get it in the mail.And sure enough, you know, T-Hawk is with us today to show off his new look.
さらにですね、もうジュリという今回。
So also joining the roster is this new female character that you see behind me. Her name is Judy. She is kind of a pioneer in the Street Fighter world, in as much as she is the first Korean character we've done, and she's also the first Taekwondo user. So that's kind of our bad for neglecting Taekwondo, even though it's an Olympic sport and it's very popular. You know, once we realize that.You know, Taekwondo was kind of the one missing piece in the Street Fighter martial arts universe. We thought it'd be a great opportunity to introduce a Korean character as well. So we did that. But rather than just have a girl Taekwondo user, which on her own might be a little on the boring side, we decided to spice her up a little, give her an interesting storyline. She's involved with SIN, the weapons manufacturer that Seth runs, as you may remember from 4. So she has kind of a bad girl streak to her, kind of an edge. She may or may not be a quote-unquote good guy in the traditional sense.You also notice she has sort of an erotic kind of look to her. You know, it is still a T-rated game. She's not going to just come out and shake her lady parts around, so to speak. But she does have kind of a sexy sort of edge to her that you don't often see in Street Fighter characters. So that's kind of a unique thing she has going for her.
もうキャラクター数に関してはですね、もう僕ら今開発チームの中。
So we're looking to add about 8 characters to Super Street Fighter 4. As you remember, with Super Street Fighter 2, we added 4 characters to that game. So we thought we should at least double that this time around to really give it some punch and make it have some impact.As far as the balance of new characters and returning characters, I think you're going to see a greater emphasis on returning characters, just because this is a game that's sort of directed at the fans, and we've had a lot of requests specifically for a lot of specific characters from specific series, so we want to be sure to sort of answer the requests from the fans before we put too much energy into new characters. That said, Judy probably won't be the only one. We're working on a few designs right now for other possible brand new characters. We think the game could use... You know, a little spice, a little something new to freshen it up. It's just going to come down to, you know, conversing with the director and figuring out what characters would work well with the overall balance of the game before we know exactly which new character is going to make it in. But there's definitely a lot of options we're working with right now.
やはりストリートファイターシリーズっていうのはバージョンアップすることでですね、新しい。
So of course, you know, naturally with this genre, it's only natural to for the game to evolve a little bit, you know, as it versions up, so as the versions go up and new versions are released, you know, there's going to be perhaps changes in the amount of frames a certain moves take, or some additional moves for existing characters. Those sort of things are a given, I think, for the genre, so you'll see some things like that. You'll also see some other features that fans have been asking for. You know, once again, to emphasize, you know, this really is about the fans, so they've been asking for, you know, certain modifications to existing modes. You know, wouldn't it be great if this kind of mode was in it, that sort of thing. Believe me when I say we've been...listening very hard at stuff like that and paying a lot of attention to message boards and that sort of thing. So you'll definitely see the kind of changes you might expect and also a few surprises as well. This is definitely a large-scale update we're dealing with here.
非常に今回ありがたかったのが、もう
多分 I think we've actually hit an interesting kind of time period in the life cycle of Street Fighter where, you know, kind of everything that was old is new again, where it's almost so old that it feels new. And it certainly feels new to people that were raised on more of the 3D fighters. So to them, the idea of...You know, something that plays completely in 2D, something that's very responsive like this, is actually very new and fresh, whereas to us, it's kind of like putting on a pair of comfortable shoes. So we're actually getting a lot of positive feedback from the younger set. You'd be surprised, actually, how many younger players are playing Street Fighter 4. You know, I was at the EVO tournament recently in Vegas. There were a lot of younger people playing. Of course, the winners were the hardcore vets, but that didn't stop some of the younger folks from putting their feet in the ring. So it's, you know, it's really interesting to see how they react, but, you know, it feels fresh to them because they weren't around 17, 18 years ago to enjoy Street Fighter 2 the way we did.
まずリリースなんですけど
So we're looking at a console-only release, which is kind of unfortunate. I know a lot of the Japanese arcade players, and as you know, arcades are still pretty popular, still have a lot of life left in them in Asia. A lot of the players, I think, were expecting it. We even had some petitions, so some players that wanted an arcade update. You know, I'll take the blame for that. I probably could have worked harder inside the company to convince the higher-ups that we should do an arcade version. Fortunately, it didn't go that well. I do plan on repaying them somehow, all these fans that really wanted it. In the future, someday I'll do something in the arcade for those guys. But unfortunately for them, and fortunately for you, who won't have to wait for you know, for a home port, it's going to be a home version only affair, and we're looking to release it in spring of next year, of 2010. So just when it starts warming up outside, you can kind of heat things up yourself with some old-school fighting action inside.